Hey guys, in this video we are going to determine the domain and the range of several types of graphs. We're going to start with this parabola, and we're going to start with domain. So when you are considering the domain, think about your x values, and you want to look for boundaries and arrows that are pointing left and right, because your domain, you're thinking the left behavior of the graph and the right behavior of the graph. Looking at the arrows on this graph, they are pointing in both of those directions. There's a left-facing one and there's a right-facing one. Now that left arrow is said to approach negative infinity. It's not a boundary, but it is where it's approaching, and that's part of the domain. The right arrow is approaching positive infinity. Now, because your domain includes both of these, the negative infinity and the positive infinity, you could say that that's all real numbers, or you can express that in interval notation with parentheses from negative infinity to positive infinity. You always go from your least possible value to your greatest possible value. Let's look at the range on this graph. So if the domain was the x values, your range is going to be your y values. And again, you're going to check for boundaries, and you're going to look for arrows pointing this time down and up. So we're going to take a look at the graph, and it looks like this graph has a clear bottom. There's no arrows pointing down, but we do have two arrows that are pointing up. So let's look at the bottom of the graph first. Where is that resting on the y-axis? It is a y value of 4. The bottom sits on the positive 4 on the y-axis. So that is going to be the range starts at positive 4. It increases upward. Those arrows point upward to the top to positive infinity because the arrows are going to keep that graph going. So to express this in interval notation, you're going to use a bracket on the 4 for the bottom as your least possible value, and then it approaches infinity as your greatest possible value. And that's the range for this graph. I'm going to show you another example with a different type of graph next. So this is an ellipse or an oval, and you're going to look at the domain and range for this graph on which there are no arrows. So starting with the domain, you're still going to think of x values, and you will look for those boundaries since there's no arrows. And we are still looking at the left of the graph and the right. You want to identify the leftmost part of that graph and the rightmost part. It looks like the leftmost part of this graph is resting at negative 4 on the x-axis, and the rightmost part is resting at positive 2 on the x-axis. Those are the boundaries of the graph. The graph extends in an interval from negative 4 to positive 2, and you use brackets because it's a boundary. It's not an unlimited, it's not where it's approaching anything infinitely. Now let's look at the range of the graph. And this time we're going to think about our y values, and we're still going to be looking for those boundaries, but this time we're also checking the bottom and the top. So looking at the graph, the bottom of the graph rests at a y value of negative 3, and the top of the graph rests at a y value of 1. So this interval with brackets is going to range from negative 3 to positive 1. And that's how you would handle this kind of graph. I have a few more examples. Okay, so for the left graph, let's start with the domain, and we're going to think about x values, and we're going to identify that those arrows do indicate left behavior and right behavior on this graph. So we're going to see that the left, it will approach negative infinity in a leftward direction, this graph will, and it will also approach positive infinity in a rightward direction. So you can express that as all real numbers, or you can use the interval negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay, let's think about the range next, which includes y values, and those same arrows can be used because they're also pointing up and down. So the bottom of the graph, it's going to continue and approach negative infinity, and the top of the graph will continue and approach positive infinity. Again, you can express that as all real numbers or as the range negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay, let's look at the second graph. This is a vertical line, so it's a little bit different. The domain of this line, if you think about just x values, well, there's really only one x value. It kind of has a boundary on the left. It doesn't go past 2 in a leftward direction, and neither does it go past 2 in a rightward direction. So the domain, instead of using an integral here, because it's just one value, you're going to use set notation, which are the braces, and you're going to indicate that there's only one value, which is 2. The domain of this function is 2. For the range of this function, you're going to look at the arrows that are pointing up and down, the y values. So the bottom arrow does approach negative infinity, and the top arrow approaches positive infinity. So that interval will be negative infinity to positive infinity, or of course you can express that as all real numbers. So those are the domain and range for the second graph. The last thing I'm going to do is pause the video so that you can practice a little bit. So go ahead and pause. And I'll show you the domain and range with explanations for these three graphs. If you have questions on these, just contact your instructor, and otherwise, good luck practicing domain and range.